morning, everyone. I think I slept about 1 hour last night and I feel so horrible today. I feel like hot and tired and I don't know, like dizzy. I'm just thinking way too much. Like there's something that's really bothering me. It's been bothering me lately and I can't stop thinking about it. And I don't really want to tell you guys about it yet. Maybe I will later, but basically I have a decision to make and there's two consequences, there's two outcomes, and both outcomes have negative consequences. So I'm not really sure which way to go, and yeah, it's been on my mind, I can't stop thinking about it, and then that among other things. I think I got like 1 hour sleep, so if I look tired today, that is why. But anyways, two sort of homeward things that I want to share with you guys that I bought recently. First of all, it's the Vitamix, which I opened this morning and showed you guys. I unboxed it. I got the Vitamix 500 series, and I've been debating getting this one for a while. It's super expensive, but let me tell you, when I just tried that, that was amazing. It crushed ice in like 1 second. My other blender was not good for ice, and it would take a long time and it would get really heated and have a smell, and I'd have to keep stopping it and stirring it, and it would take like 10 minutes, not 10 minutes, it would take like, I don't know, 5 minutes to make a smoothie, which I know isn't like a big problem, Taylor, come on, but I don't know, I enjoy cooking and I like to make a lot of soups and smoothies, so I thought that I would treat myself and buy myself a professional blender. It also came with this amazing book of like tons of recipes of smoothies, soups, sauces, just like everything. Can't wait to look through this. And the other thing I got, so as you know, I usually will make a fresh coffee in the morning with grounded coffee beans. And this is, I got this. And it's like this little container that after you make your coffee, the little grinds that are left over inside the thing, I don't know what it's called, you just put them into here and you pile them up, and these can be recycled. So usually I would just throw them in the garbage or pour them down the sink after I was done making it, but I can put it into here. And these are amazing to put in your plants before you water them or before it rains to help them grow, because I think it helps produce like nitrogen or something. Anyways, it works amazing in fertilizer. So they can be recycled for that. And also I remember Tyra Banks saying something about coffee grinds being used as good like cellulite cream or cellulite exfoliator. So I'm gonna put this in a container and put it in my shower and use it to like exfoliate, because I think it increases the circulation in that area because of the caffeine or something. I don't know, but I'm gonna try it. So I thought that was handy and I just wanna share those two little things with you guys this morning. I am ready for the day. I actually ate a big bowl of pasta for lunch and now I'm ready to go out. I didn't tell you what I'm doing today yet, and Charlotte's actually in Tokyo now. Oh, she's messaging me. Yeah, Charlotte's actually in Tokyo now, so we're all gonna get together. I think she's leaving tomorrow, so I'm gonna go meet her soon. She's getting her hair done, and there is this new ice, vegan, gluten-free, everything-free ice cream place that opened up here in Harajuku, and I've been getting like a million tags on their stuff on their Instagram, Twitter, and everything that you guys want me to go and check it out. So we are gonna go do that, and then I can show you guys, for those of you who don't live here or those of you that are coming here later, you can see what it's like. I can't wait to try that. And then we'll probably go to dinner, and then tonight I'm doing something that I normally wouldn't do, and that's karaoke. Charlotte actually organized this karaoke night with a bunch of us, and normally I would say no to these type of things because I'm like terrified. I've always been terrified of karaoke for two reasons. Like, one, I'm terrified of singing in front of people. Like, I can't do it. I won't even sing in front of my family, really. Like, actually try and sing, like not being stupid sing, like try and sing, I'm scared. And two, being in big groups of people that I don't know, like, yeah, around people that I haven't met before, and in those sort of big groups, I'm always scared and get some, like, anxiety of meeting, like, a lot of new people at once. And the reason being, like, ever since starting YouTube, I always feel like people might have an idea about me or, like, thought up some sort of way I'm supposed to be in their head. And I'm always scared of, like, disappointing them when I meet them. Whether that be appearance or personality or anything, maybe I'll say the wrong thing. Maybe they'll, like, think bad about me, and I don't know, like, maybe they won't like something I said, or they'll make up something that wasn't true about me. Either way, I always feel really anxious about meeting a lot of new people. But I've been thinking about it, and I've decided to say yes more. I really want to do more this year. I want to say yes. I want to step out of my comfort zone. I want to do things I normally wouldn't do. I want to meet more people. I want to travel more, like, travel more, not only like around the world, but also around Japan, because who knows how long I'll be living here for. So I really want to just like see more and do more and discover more. And I really want to make this year the year that I do more. So that is going to start tonight with karaoke. I'm going to go, I'm going to meet new people, and I'm going to do something I probably would say no to. Quick outfit of the day. Shirt and skirt. I got it in this shop in Shibuya 109, which is now closed. It was like a little boutique shop selling Korean brand stuff. And I guess the brand is MHT. I want to say the skirt and t-shirt are the same brand. I'll check in the tag and I'll link anything that I can find in the description box. But the shirt is sort of this loose baggy shirt. I kind of tied it up with a clear elastic here, which is hidden by this jean jacket, which is from, I forget everything, guys. I'm going to link it below, or I'll put it in writing here. This hat was also from that same shop. And socks from Adidas. I'm not sure what shoes I'm gonna wear yet. Let me go see that. And on the lips, I put the Kylie Jenner kit in Candy K. Okay, so I just went into the wrong hair salon. That was a little bit embarrassing, because I just like walked in and looked around for Charlotte and she wasn't there, but now I found the right one. Here we go.
Kim's here, Charlotte's here. Look at her hair. Can I show your hair?
Yeah, it's not done yet, but
it's very ashy. Looks amazing. Super ashy.
Love it. It's so soft.
So no more colors. No more.
Yeah, the color's done.
You're not gonna put in any purple. I mean, you're not gonna put in any pink or anything.
No.
Nice.
Gradation is clean.
Yeah, it's gradient, right?
Yeah.
Like balayage style.
This is silver and ash.
Silver ash. Yeah.
I
think gray. Gray hair is so cool. I would love to try that.
Yeah.
If I could, but I can't.
I love it.
Nice. Your style is different today.
Yeah,
I like it.
Because I don't have any clean clothes. Because I have it on. I took it on my trip, and then I haven't had time to wash my clothes.
Oh, it's cute though. Thank you. Oh, look where Kim got her dog. Where did you get that?
From Pet Paradise in Harajuku.
Oh, I know which one.
It was only like 3,000 yen, so it's not too bad.
That is so adorable.
So I really hope it fits her. I'm scared it's going to be too small.
Tell your family to take a photo and send it, because I want to see what she looks like. Oh my god, that's so adorable. Excited. We're done at the hair salon, and we're trying to find the ice cream place.
Yep. Kim is leading the navigation system.
The little kids.
Oh.
I'm like attracted to it. Charlotte, it's not for you. Oh, there's like two chairs. That is cute.
One and then a shampoo chair.
Oh.
So cute.
It's such a nice day.
I love how there's no people here. Like, what's going on?
Yeah, where is everyone?
It's never like this.
I want to know, will the flavors change or?
We just opened 3 days ago, so we started 6 flavors. But yeah, I think we're gonna change the flavor each season.
Yeah. Okay.
Please pack her up for spring.
You guys gotta come try this if you're in Harajuku area. So delicious. Charlotte got lemon and
rum raisin.
Rum raisin, and Kim got vanilla. What's the stuff on top there?
Cranberry powder.
Oh, cranberry.
So good, right?
The flavor is so real. Like better than ice cream.
So healthy.
It's better than
it's
ice cream,
healthy.
But not like heavy. What is this? Carrots.
Carrots. Matage.
Bronwyn's here. I didn't film you yet. We just met today. We're both from really small cities nearby each other,
so close.
We're already like bonding. We're done dinner now. It was absolutely delicious, and now we're heading over to karaoke. Yay. We're in Ikebukuro, by the way. Okay, this room is slightly terrifying. There's like skeletons on the wall. I'm already terrified of playing basketball. Yeah. So random. Oh god. The skeleton faces light up. I'm already terrified of karaoke. This is terrifying.
Usually like pineapple juice, right?
Yeah, pineapple juice.
Rooms with the neon lights usually light up. But I don't know.
There's... Do we get costumes and props?
Some places do. I don't think that messaging Charlotte already. If you guys are wondering, Mimei was also invited, but she's not feeling well today, so that's why she wasn't there.
Did you miss me? You did. Oh, I missed you.
Right, I just want to talk about something because
I'm sure most of you guys have already heard the news, but there is a girl named Christina Grimmie who was shot. She was a singer and also a YouTuber, and she was shot after her concert. She was signing autographs and somebody came in and shot her, and yeah, she passed away. And I heard this happened yesterday, and I heard the news today, and I'm just like really, really shocked. Like, I can't believe that. I feel angry, and like, it's not fair that someone can just come in and decide that her life should be over. And like, I'm also a bit mad that there wasn't any security. Apparently the guy had two guns and like a knife. There was no pat down and no security check, and even the security like weren't armed at all. So like, nobody was really protecting her, and I feel like, I don't know, there was a lot more that could have been done to save her, but I don't know, I'm sure like you can't dwell on like this could have happened or this could have been done, but it's just making me like think a lot today and like think about how short life is and how you never know what could happen to you or to somebody you love, and life is just like so fragile and precious. And I just hope that you guys are doing what you want to do and doing what you love and making each day really count. Like, make sure you ask yourself, like, if something were to happen tomorrow, like, if this was your last day, would you be doing what you're doing today? Like, obviously you have certain restrictions, like you have to work, you have to make money and and things like that, or you need to stay with your family, but I don't know, just try to do more of what makes you happy and try to make other people happy and ask yourself like what you're doing each day to better your life or better other people's life or make the world a better place. Yeah, I don't know. Just really got me thinking about life in general and like how you really just don't know what can happen or how much time you have here. So also, I got a letter today from a viewer that really touched my heart. Let me try and find it. From Zary UPL. And she mentioned that she's bad at writing letters and she like decided against writing me a letter some days ago, but she finally decided to write to me today because of what happened to Christina, and it made her change her mind. And she said people should know what they mean to others before it's too late. So she just told me about herself and about her story and like what I mean to her, and like she wrote me a really long nice letter, and it really touched my heart, and it really made me think more today about that, like that you should never hold back the things you want to say or the things you want to do. You should just go and do them because life is short, and you really never know. So do that. Make sure you guys tell the people that you love them, spend more time with them. Do more of what makes you happy. Just make this world a better place and try to leave it in a better way than it was when you entered it, if that makes sense. I am completely exhausted. But today was fun, and yeah, I hope you enjoyed today's vlog. Please give a thumbs up if you did. I'm glad I went, and I'm glad I met some new people, and yes. I think I'm gonna have a really good sleep tonight. Thank you so much for watching, and I will see you in my next vlog or video. Good night!
I have a bum right in my face.